What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Rooster Reacts. It's your boy, Brad the Rooster, and today we are reacting to one of the original requested songs from MGK. This is 27. I'm going to go ahead and check this out. Please click the link in my description down below. Please go support MGK. Without his music, we would not be doing this reaction. We got to support the artist, all. It's all about the artist. If you want to support this channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button, but if not, no harm, no foul. Y'all know I'm turning the leaf over. I am an MGK fan at this point. I never thought I would have said that. So I think this is 4 years ago. So this might be the rapping MGK era, which I've been open about not being a huge fan of. So I'm gonna go into this open-minded. I should pull the lyrics up. Shoot. Man, I am on my game today, y'all. You come here for professionality, for sure. Let's pull the lyrics up, because I don't want to miss any bars, which I probably still will miss something, because it's me, after all. But let's go ahead and get into this. I'm excited.
The feeling I had when I wrote that was like a really sad feeling, topped with this like beautiful chorus that made me feel like, damn, what would it be like when like all the dreams are gone? Like, if it's all over tomorrow, it's not like if it's all over, like your life is over. It's like if like this is the highest we can ever get.
The loyalty that you experience when you're down and up is like what makes it all worth it. You know, we all see the bigger vision, you know what I mean? And I just can't wait till we get to that point where we feel like, damn, we finally made it, you know what I mean? And then we can like go back to being how we were when we were 18 and just making things with no like weight on our shoulders anymore. But right now the pressure's on, and that's what life is.
So clearly, you know,
like we want to be great. So until we're that, it's like we're just...
All right, so we're clearly seeing like home footage. Was this MGK's house growing up, right here? Let me know in the comments. I think this is gonna get pretty serious. I was looking at like, shout out to Genius. I'm not sponsored by them. We don't have sponsors on this channel, y'all. Let's be honest. But 27 maintains a theme of Machine Gun Kelly's potential premature death at the age of 27. MGK speaks to his fans on this track, sending the messages that should he die, his music will endure, and his fans will always remember him by. Is that because of like the 27 Club? Is he just kind of assuming that he's going to be joining the insane club of all the like some of the greatest musicians ever that died at 27? You can look it up. I wonder what sparked him to make that, or to have that assumption. Or is this just in case? I don't know.
With no like weight on our shoulders anymore.
He just said my name!
But right now the pressure's on, and that's what life is, you know? Like we want to be great. So until we're that, it's like we're just pushing and we're learning along the way. But we're gonna do it, you know, as family, or it's just not gonna happen.
And if I must go and die at 27, then at least I know I died a legend.
Oof.
Now, will you roll?
Hold up. I'll tell you what, I'm reacting to some emotional songs today. I mean, that's a great bar. I mean, for as sad as that bar is, and if I must go and die at 27, then at least I know I died a legend. Oof. I don't know what's in the water today, but I am picking some downers.
I died a legend. Now, will you roll and ride like we're together and keep the vibe alive inside forever? Feel me forever.
Oh, dealers. From past dealers where people counted me out till I grew up. Hold up, MGK. You gotta slow down a second. I'm losing my cursor here. What is going on with my computer? They say I need to slow down, but I don't know how. Look, I'm not a rapper. I'm not in the entertainment industry. That's not my world. But, and this isn't even necessarily completely related, but it just reminded me, like, I have this constant kind of drive mentality where I gotta constantly be striving for the next goal. And when I get that goal, then, okay, now I'm here. What's the next goal I gotta strive for? And there's this constant, like, go get them. And maybe it's because of the way I grew up in a very unstable household and with an addict for a mother and all these things. Life was not great growing up in a lot of ways. I won't talk about that too much because it's irrelevant to this. But there is this thing in me, and I get this from this bar, like never being able to truly be comfortable and kind of live in the moment because you're chasing the next thing. And that inability to slow down. And I'm guilty of that to this day. I'm working on it. Shout out to therapy. But I'm not perfect at it. And man, these songs, I tell you, I just reacted to a Pentatonix song that, like, This Is Christmas to Me, that's super sad. I just reacted to the 1975, which that song was, like, great, but kind of sad. I need something to pick me up.
Real fellas, from past dealers where people counted me out till I grew up to count millions, like I guess it's good to be different, huh? I'm a star, so the sky isn't the limit, huh? I'm living like it's my last day. Smoke as if there's not already 27 roaches in the ashtray. Smile as if no one hated it all. As if anyone understood anytime I evolved. Tell me, what do you do when what you dream comes true? Buy a Bentley and look just like you. How I'm supposed to write a song when I'm famous and all the pain is created. I need to overdose on inspiration. 27.
What? How am I supposed to write a song when I'm famous and all the pain is created? I need to overdose on inspiration. 20. Isn't that really kind of like the whole thing with hip hop and rap? Is like a lot of rappers start with, I mean, I don't want to say all rappers, but the theme is usually really rough childhood. You got to use that inspiration to make music. Then you get famous, and it's like, well, now you're rich. What? It's hard to pull from, like, early days. But in my experience, being in therapy, even no matter how much, you know, financially more stable you get, those things still stay with you. So I sort of have turned to my opinions on, well, now you're rich and famous, so all those problems go away. They don't really go away. They're still there. And money does not fix that. I'll say that money doesn't help. Obviously, I do think money does make things a lot easier, you know, going to the doctors and doing what you have to do, but there is something to it. And I would really like to know what the reason for the diss track to Eminem was about. Why did that happen? Because I think I discovered MGK through the diss track. And I watched it, then I watched Eminem's Kill Shot, Rap Devil, right? Rap Devil is MGK, yes. That's how I discovered MGK. So I'm an Eminem fan. So I was already like, well, who's this guy? Why did it happen? I'd love to know in the comments. Please let me know. Because this is good.
I need to overdose on inspiration.
I was wrong.
27. Why don't you just go home? But I came right now. I'm a rolling.
Hot.
must go and fly away and kiss my baby girl goodnight.
Oh, man.
And if this really is goodbye.
Chester Bennington, shout to Chester.
Set the city on fire.
R.I.P. to Chester. So sad.
Can you take me higher?
If Kells was standing here right now, what would you say to him?
Can you take me higher?
Thank you for your music. It's beautiful.
Yeah, you helped us in our hardest times. It's wonderful.
Take me higher.
That's what it is. Y'all, I know I'm pausing it a lot. We're already at 11 minutes. Jeez. I have a lot more to go, but shout out to Machine Gun Kelly. You know, if your music is resonating with somebody, then you're doing a good job. No matter what other people say, no matter the quality that it might be on paper. I'm not saying Machine Gun Kelly is a bad artist. I'm not saying that. But even if an artist on paper is not good, if there's a really bad rapper, his name's Ice JJ Fish. If you know who Ice JJ Fish is, you're a real one. He makes, I mean, he is not a great singer or R&B artist at all, but his music makes me just laugh and smile. And so in some ways, I'm like, dude, you're good. You're making me convey an emotion, and that is a good thing. As long as it's not hate. Don't hate anything. But shout out to MGK. I'm talking a lot, but I needed this in a way.
Wonderful. Take me higher.
That's what an arena looks like. Ah!
That's gotta be crazy.
My voice to listen to. What is a beautiful life without a beautiful death? What is a beautiful mind? How is our beauty defined? Is it for you to decide? Is it my duty to die? No matter how I'm remembered, just let me be remembered. Kells.
Yeah. Forever young, though. Always be those crazy kids running wide-eyed down the boulevard. 27.
Dude, it's so good. Shout out to Ryan Hardy for directing this. Let's just go back to something. Oh, cool. MGK's face. Got a little smug on it. Okay. I think in hindsight, retrospective, I know this is a long reaction. If you're still watching to this point, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. The one thing they don't talk about on YouTube is that it doesn't matter how many views you get, it doesn't matter how many subscribers you get. What matters is how much of the video people watch. So if you're here, thank you so much. I think in hindsight, there's a beautiful meaning behind this song. It's not necessarily about him thinking that he's going to die at 27. I think what he's trying to say, and correct me if I'm wrong, is that if he were to die at 27, he's lived a great life. He's made a name for, he's made himself into a legend, so he can go knowing that his legacy will live on forever. And to me, that's beautiful. If you can, I mean, I want us all to live to ripe old age of well past 100. Whatever, however long you want to live. But the reality of it is that doesn't happen for everybody. And I hope that, for me, my goal would hope to be that if my ticket is pulled, that I lived a beautiful, happy life up to that point. And I didn't have any regrets of things that I didn't do. And I think that's what MGK is saying here. And if that's what he's saying, then shout out to him. He is a legend in his own right. This was awesome, y'all. Thank you for watching. This is a 16-minute reaction. I apologize that it's so long. But it had to be said. Hope you all have a wonderful day. Speaking of all this, you got 24 hours in a day. Go make the most of it. Go do something fun. Go to bed tonight thinking today was a good day. I'll catch you on the next one. I am Rowdy, and I am Ellie. See ya.